So after again, Jehoshaphat, he says that y'all don't have to worry. Y'all can just stand still and see what?
Salvation of the Lord.
Okay, and then they say that Jehoshaphat began to worship the Lord, and then the Levites began to do what? The Levites began to, what did they say? The Levites began to worship the Lord. All right, the Levites, I believe, 2 Chronicles 20. It was really amazing how that victory was won, but all of the victories in the Old Testament were basically won the same way. Verse 17, ye shall not need to fight in this battle. Set yourselves, stand ye still, and see the salvation of the Lord with you, O Judah and Jerusalem. Fear not. See, look at that. Fear not. Fear not. See, fear is always what? Staring us always in the face.
Yeah.
All right. Fear not. Not be dismayed. Tomorrow, go out against them, for the Lord will be with you.
Amen.
Jehoshaphat bowed his head with his face to the ground, and all Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem fell before the Lord, worshiping the Lord. Imagine the worship can help out a lot too. So, you know, these are some practical things that we can do to really get our faith at a level that it can really work for us. And Jehoshaphat, have I read that before?
We're on 19.
19. And the Levites of the children of the Kohites and of the children of the Kohites stood up to praise the Lord God of Israel with a loud voice on high. With a soft voice on high.
Loud voice.
All right. Now, another thing that will help you to get a breakthrough, too, is lifting your voice. You'd be surprised how that can overcome fear, because most times when you lift your voice, you will experience a brokenness. And the sacrifices of God is a broken spirit. And we cut ourselves real short when we just praise God, maybe a little above a whisper. All right, y'all hear what I'm saying tonight? Mm-hmm. All these quiet, secret servants. Bible said, open your mouth, what? Let the voice of your praise be what?
Heard.
And that's one thing that we got to get over, saints. I remember in the old church, the sanctified church, I love the sanctified folk. Boy, they would have a prayer meeting. They would have a testimony meeting.
Yes.
And all of them would open their mouths. You can go to a sanctified church now, listen to them sing, and come back and listen to us. Oh, let's move on. Amen. And all of them get up and testify.
Yes.
That's how I was trained. Everybody get up and testify. Every service.
Amen.
Might be an hour, but we learn how to overcome fear. We learn how to what? Open our mouths and praise God. Something happened while you testify. You overcome what? The devil. You overcome a whole lot of things when you what? Open your mouth. All right, so that's a very important thing. Now, we're learning some things tonight that really will help us to overcome our fears, our doubts, our reluctances, sometimes we hesitate, and sometimes we just sit on the sideline, and many times let the blessings of the Lord pass us by. But you can see here that I like that they praised the Lord with a loud voice on high. Everybody said that. They praised the Lord of Israel with a what?
Loud voice.
All right. I want everybody to praise the Lord with a loud voice. Some of y'all can't talk loud. Some of y'all can't talk loud. Everybody said praise the Lord.
Praise the
Praise the Lord.
I told you. Y'all call that loud. Now, who was that Monday night that talked about how loud people are in football games?
Sharon.
Where's your sister Sharon? Is she here tonight?
Yes, she's over there.
What did you tell us about Praise the Lord at football games?
Sing it for repeat it.
Some people are loud at
football games and they are at church.
All right, how
do
you like that?
Yeah.
You
don't think it should be a distinction.
All right, everybody say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
All right, now how does that compare with a football game? Was somebody about to make a decision? How does that compare, Brother Beauty? God, who's that? No comparison. Oh, Jesus. All right, if we could get saints to open their mouth like we did in the whole church, well, we could really experience a whole lot more liberty and freedom in the kingdom of God. All right, Brother Rod, Brother Wayne, y'all tell us, what will it take for saints to open up a little bit more? That's what I want to know. What will it take?
Well, they have to overcome that fear of speaking, I guess, and understanding that if you just open up, you will get released. That's always worked for me. I'm not afraid to speak.
Yeah, he's always the loudest one in the room. That's good.
Well, it requires, like Brother Ron says, what is it that expels fear? Action. You know, open up your mouth, whatever you need to do, it's some form of action. I want to just piggyback on something Brother Holman said, and that was about, does it help, something to the effect about remembering. And all through the Bible, we are challenged to remember. In Deuteronomy, I was looking in the 8th chapter, is full of the remember, don't forget. And we just read about Jonah when he remembered. Mm-hmm. And it always, it helps to, in a challenging situation, and it seems like insurmountable, that I know what God's promises are. And when I can remember all those times he brought me out, that really helps my faith to soar, when you can remember. Mm-hmm. But if you forget, and we're not to be forgetful hearers, but if we forget, we don't have that much to draw on. So we're challenged to remember. So it really does help me to remember.
Okay, all right. Sister, you got another revelation? Y'all like that one?
Amen. Yeah.
That's not a revelation. That's okay, what the word
that's
said.
Good. Remembering really helps out a lot because remembering, okay, here's what it says.
Where are you?
Okay. Christy. Where am I? I'm in a book that you don't have.
Right? I have that book.
Okay. By cultivating a spirit of thanksgiving, we increase our capacity and ability to receive from God. Thanksgiving activates and starts the wheel of faith moving and sets the stage for the supernatural to work. It overcomes many obstacles, is that right?
Obstacles,
whatever, and hindrances to faith. It is impossible to thank God for things he has done for us without experiencing a surge of faith in our spirits.
Yes.
It doesn't take long to get excited about what he is about to do. Mm-hmm. When we begin to reflect on what God has done.
That's remembering.
Yes.
That was the point you were making, right?
Yes, absolutely.
All right. Brother Holman, you brought a good point. Sister Hill confirmed.
I just piggybacked on
it. All right. That's, she piggybacked on your revelation. Okay. Now, they shouted with a loud voice. Sister Maryne, y'all hear me over there? Fan going too loud. All right. They praised the Lord with a loud voice. Okay, now verse 20. And they rose up early in the morning and went forth into the wilderness of Tekoa. And as they went forth, Jehoshaphat
stood and said, "Hear me, O Judah, and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem. Believe in the Lord your God, so shall ye be established. Believe his prophets, so shall ye what?
Prosper.
And when he had consulted with the people, he appointed singers unto the Lord, and that would praise the beauty of holiness as they went out before the army, and to say, they had to say something.
Praise the Lord
for his what?
Mercy endureth forever.
All right, that's what they had to say. And when they began to sing and to praise, the Lord set ambushments against the children of Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir. It was three big nations that were coming against them, which were come against Judah, and they were smitten. For the children of Ammon and Moab stood up against the inhabitants of Mount Seir, utterly to slay and destroy them. And when they had made an end of the inhabitants of Seir, everyone helped to destroy another. So they ended up destroying themselves. All right. And when Judah came towards the watchtower in the wilderness, they looked unto the multitude, and behold, they were dead bodies fallen to the earth. And how many escaped?
None.
None of them escaped. And when Jehoshaphat and his people came to take away the spoil of them, they found among them in abundance both what?
Riches
from the dead bodies and precious jewels, which they had what? Stripped off for themselves more than they could what?
Carry away.
And they were how many days?
3 days.
In gathering of what?
The spoil.
It was so much.
All right, so they didn't have to use any weapons. Someone said the weapons of our warfare are not what?
Carnal,
but they are what?
Mighty
through God. So, okay, now y'all point out some things that could really help us to overcome our enemies and to help us to get God involved in bringing victory to us when we are confronted difficult circumstances. What weapons did they employ in this story?
Praise.
And
remembering.
Yes.
All right, a combination of things, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right, started out with what? Call them all together?
Mm-hmm.
So we need to what?
Fast.
We need to seek God.
Mm-hmm.
Fast and pray. All right, then what else? Then Jehoshaphat what? Prayed a very powerful prayer. One thing about that prayer, he was simply calling God to what?
Remembrance
of things that he had promised his people whenever they confronted what? Evil. All right, that's all he did. Just call God to remember as to what he had promised. And then the Holy Ghost began to what? Manifest and began to speak. How important it is for the Holy Ghost to speak to us and give us direction.
Yes, amen.
All right, that might be a little revelation there. Fasting and prayer and praying the word, and these are things that really will help what? Amen. To open the eyes of your understanding up, God can show you some things. All right? But the part that we just got through reading was that these people were very worshipful from the king on down. He fell down on his face and began to what? Worship. If I fell down on my face and worship the Lord, like Jehoshaphat, what would y'all say tonight?
Praise God.
All right. Now, amen. So it's in order for men of God to fall down sometimes under the anointing. It's also appropriate for what? The people.
Right.
To open their mouths wide too, right?
My God.
And it's also appropriate for the what? The singers. Amen. To go forth singing, amen, what? Praise the Lord for his what?
Mercy.
Mercies. That is still appropriate today. We can shout that in every prayer meeting. Praise the Lord for his what?
Mercy.